गुड आफ्टरनून, इज माय वॉइस क्लियर?
यस सर।
ओके, डू यू हैव एनी क्वेश्चन फ्रॉम माय प्रीवियस लेक्चर? यू हैव वन एट एंड यू कैन आस्क। जस्ट फील कंफर्टेबल एंड आस्क इफ यू हैव एनी। Is it everything clear from my previous lecture? Okay.
Yes, sir.
Perfect. And today we're going to discuss about the population and the sample. So, any volunteer from that class, can you define what is a population? Here, please just feel comfortable and tell me what is population.
Set of group of living organisms that live at the same place and at the same time.
So what do you mean by that group? What do you mean by the group? Any other? Anyone else? Define population.
Like group of zoology class.
Group. Once again, you use about group. I am very, very much interested to know what is group in your.
Same species.
Okay, you move towards the biology. I do not have any problem regarding the definition of a biologist regarding the population. So please define what is population.
Group of individual or species living in the same area at the same time.
So once again, you use the word group. So when it comes to the biology, we define the population as either you use the word group. Or what do we mean by the group is the number of individuals of the same species. So in replacement of the species, you use the word group. So in biology, we define population as number of individuals of the same species living in a specific area at the specific time. We refer it as population. When it comes to the statistics, we not have a very strict biologist definition of a population, that it must require to be a living thing and it must be like within the same species. Rather, we are flexible, but the concept will remain same. If you define, if you are working on biology, your understanding of definition of a population is absolutely perfect. That population means when you include each and every individual of a specific species living in a specific area at a specific time, it's population. Perfect. But when it comes to the statistics, now statistics is not only relevant for biology. Statistics is engaged in every other sciences. For them, if we restrict ourselves to the definition of a biologist, it will become very, very difficult. So in statistics, we define the population as a complete set that includes all individuals or items. What do I mean by this? That in statistics, if I want to get the data regarding cars of a specific company in District Mirpur. So although cars, they are non-living, and as a biologist, maybe you disagree with the definition, but someone working on cars of a specific company, all those cars, if we include each and every car in a specific area, that will be the population of those cars. If someone is working on the water sources of a specific area, so all those water sources, if we include each and every water source of a specific area, all those water sources, they become population. So instead of restricting ourselves to the living organisms, we have a broader definition in statistics that it's a complete set. Another name for it, that somewhere in the literature, you will going to see a word like universal set. What do we mean by the universal set? Universal set mean each and everyone. So even in MSc Zoology Sex Master, academic session 2019-21, when I include each and everyone in this class, that will be the population of this class. So as far as the population is concerned, sometimes population is small, finite. It's possible to get data from each and everyone. I gave you an example that if I will consider your class as a population, and I define it that MSc Zoology second semester academic session 2019-21. So it will be a population, but that population is smaller population. It's a finite population. And if I need that data from you, I can collect data from each and everyone. Most of the time, the population is a very large entity. For example, if I were going to consider, okay, the human population of District Mirpur, that includes approximately 0.5 million people, very, very large. If I want to know about the population of buffalo in District Mirpur, very, very large. So when it comes to statistics, people, they are interested to know about the population. They want to know what's going on in the population. They want to know about the facts in the population. And if someone has those resources to get information or data from the population, that is the best and the most reliable and authentic information available. Give yourself a little bit of time and think that if I enroll a student and decide that the student will going to work on malaria parasite, and I want that person, okay, I'm interested to know the prevalence of malaria in District Mirpur, and I demand that student to collect data from each and every individual from District Mirpur, do you think it will be possible? So if he or she wants to qualify his or her degree, MPhil degree, he or she is supposed to collect data from each and every individual from District Mirpur. It needs lots and lots of resources, and the person may not have those resources. And the people, they want to know the facts about the population. As we have the limitation, it's always ideal, it's always desirable, and it's most authentic that we need to have a data from the population. But most of the time, it's not possible to get data from population. As our government has the resources, so they do not carry out any sampling. Rather, they have a population census. And once they have a data from the population, they are very, very authentic. Okay, they know what fraction of population is male, what fraction of the population is female. If they were going to tell you it's 48, 52, you have to trust them because it's exactly 48 to 52 because they have data from each and everyone in the every individual in the country. For example, if they were going to tell you that what fraction of the population they are children, what fraction of the population they are young, they are adults. So whatever they have the information, as they have census, as they have data from the population, they are very, very much authentic, and what they will going to tell you will be true. The purpose of telling all those things with examples is that it's always very, very much accurate, and it's always desirable that you need to have a data from population. And once you have a data from population, you do not need to do any inferential statistics. You do not need to apply those tests. Once you have a data from population, you just need descriptive statistics. You have to describe your data. Do you have any question? But as I told you, that it's most of the time it's not possible to get. I mean, only the government can have the sense for each and every one. But other than that, most of the time we do not have access to the entire population. And we fail to collect data from the population. For example, give yourself a little bit of time. If someone is working on wildlife and he wants to get data from any wild animal of a specific area, do you think that person has access to each and every wild animal? Maybe he will going to trap few animals and that's all. But even with a very large size, having a trapping for a very longer period of time, still that person cannot be certain that he or she included all those individuals, all those wild animals of a specific area. Maybe some animal is missing. So practically, it's not possible to get data all the time from everyone in the population. But if you have a data from population, the entire statistics is descriptive statistics. You just need to describe the data set. How you will going to describe that data set? If your data is interval or on ratio scale, you need to describe it either, I mean, describe center, and the other thing is describe dispersion. And if you have a data set that is measured either on ordinal scale or nominal scale, in that case, you have to describe that data set only through the frequencies. For example, male and female, it's a nominal scale data. So that's how you are going to describe it. What fraction? 48% male, 52% females. For example, 30% children, other than 30, remaining 70%. So that's all you need. But as it is not possible to collect data from each and every one, the other option is either to do nothing or to carry out a sampling. As everyone wants to know about the population, and you need it, but at the same time, you do not have access to the entire population. Only option you are left with is to carry out sample. And when you collect data, when you take sample, please do not confuse yourself. When you take sample, and on the basis of that sample is nothing else. That's we define the sample as subset of a population. The sample can be large, the sample can be small, it depends, but sample is nothing else but subset of a population. For example, if you have an entire strength of class as 50, And if I take data from 49 people, it will be sampled. If only one individual is missing, still it will be sampled. If you have a class of 50 people, if I take data from randomly 5 or 6 people, still it will be a sample. One sample will be small, other will be very large. So as you do not have access to the entire population, you are left with only samples because you want to get information about the population. And the only option is to take sample. And when you take sample, that's a very, very much punchline. When you take sample, you do not decide about sample. You take sample and based on information taken from the sample, you decide about the population. As you cannot directly decide about the population, so you need inferential statistics. I will going to elaborate this with an example. For example, if I'm interested to know that what's the average weight of students that are enrolled in MSc Zoology second semester class. If I was going to take a sample of 25 and the entire strength of the class is 50, when I take the sample of 25, do you think, is there any possibility that this sample weight will be exactly identical to the population weight? Please respond and volunteer. That the average,
so please repeat the question.
For example, if I have a class of 50 people and I'm interested to know that what's the average weight of a class, and I take a sample of 25 people, what do you think that the average weight of sample will be exactly identical to the average weight of population?
No, sir.
It's in a very, very rare occasion, maybe it's possible, but most of the time, 99.99% of the time, the average weight of a sample will be different from population. As your intention, the only objective is that when you take the sample, you decide something about the population. And any information that is being provided from the sample is majority of the time, 99.99% of the time, is different from the population. And you know that it's very common, it's a common sense that it will be different. So there is some kind of error linked to it. And as you know, that the characteristic that you get from a sample, it will be different from population. In order to resolve that issue, we apply all those inferential statistics. We take sample and then we apply the inferential statistic. We test it. And after those tests, we decide about the population. Because the purpose of taking sample is to make a decision about the population. That's a very critical concept. Is it clear? Do you have any questions?
Yes, sir.
Are you sure?
Yes, sir.
Okay, thank you. So, to take the sample, we're going to test one by one all those sampling strategies. Sometimes we take a random sample. In random sample, each and every individual, each and every identity, each and every entity will have an equal chance to be selected. But sometimes it's not possible to take the random sample and then simple random sampling, and then we move to other strategies, because once again, we're going to discuss But purpose is to tell you that when you take a sample, the purpose of taking sample is to make, based on information available in the sample, is to and to make a decision about the population. And we cannot make that decision as you see. For example, average of a sample will be different from average of population. This dispersion of a sample or variance of a sample will be different from variance of population. So you cannot decide directly. So we take the help of inferential statistics to decide our population. If you have a population, you do not need the inferential statistics. And there are two terms. And there, it's very, very important to understand these things. One is the parameter and other one is the statistic. Oh my God. Is the PPT visible to everyone? PowerPoint presentation. Is it visible?
Yes, no, it's sir. Visible, and it's population and sample.
No, on my slide it's parameter and statistic.
No, sir, wo wali nahi.
No, that.
Is it visible?
No, sir.
Parameter. No,
is
sir.
It visible? Okay. Let me
now it's again. Visible.
Is it visible now?
Yes, sir.
Parameter and statistics. Is it visible?
Yes, sir.
Okay, perfect. So there are two terms. When it comes to the population sample, there are two terms that are frequently being used. One is the parameter and one is the statistic. It's not statistics, it's statistic. Assessing. We define the parameter. It is the characteristic of a population. And it's the summary data from a population. It's the characteristic of a population and it has a fixed value. What do I mean by this? For example, when you have a data from the population, and what is the characteristic? Characteristic can be mean or average, characteristic can be median, characteristic can be mod, characteristic can be variance, characteristic can be standard deviation, characteristic can be range. So any characteristic, we name it as the parameter. Parameter has a fixed value. What do I mean by this? If I want to know about the body weight of the MSc Zoology second semester class, and take data from the population, and I measure the weight of each and every one, and once I have measured the weight of each and every one, then I just calculate, I take the mean. I take the mean by just adding all those values and then dividing it by, it will be summation x. And my mouse cursor becomes summation x. Just adding all those values and then by total number of values, and then I was going to get the average weight. So I will ask you a question. Now I have a weight. Let's put the average weight of the class is 45. If I will ask you that, if I was going to take that data again, and I take the data from each and every one again, I measure the body weight again, and then once again, I just calculate the average. Do you think will it be different from previous one? Do you think it will be different from my previous calculation?
No, sir. It can be different.
How it can be different? If I just exclude all those measurement errors, there should not be any measurement error. The instrument is very, very, measuring instrument is absolutely precise. And my calculations are absolutely perfect. If I take the body weight of each and every one now, and if I was going to take the body weight of each and every one again, will it be different?
There will be no delay in the measurement.
Okay, that's an answer. I agree with that. But if you just ignore that those very small minute changes.
All right, sir, I agree. It won't change.
It will same. Okay. If I will ask you, if I try to get a data regarding your age, what's the average age of this class? So with weight, I do agree with this that there is very slight change in the weight with time. Perfect. But let's suppose if I will ask you about the average age of a class, and it's in years only, not in days or minutes. So let's suppose that if I ask the age of each and every one, and then I just take the average and average age, let's suppose I have an average age of 22 years. And next I will going to collect the data from each and every one. Do you think will it change?
No, sir.
If I'm going to take the data third time, will it change?
No, sir.
That means, okay. So that is a characteristic of a population. So it has a fixed value. For example, if I was going to calculate the standard deviation, maybe at this time you do not know standard deviation, but you just need to know that it's an average deviation of the values from mean. So if I just calculate the standard deviation, do you think the standard deviation of my first time and the second time and third time, will it change? Standard deviation is another characteristic of a population. Will it change?
No, sir, it won't change.
It will remain as it is. So the characteristic of a population, we name it as the parameter, and it has a fixed value. Its value do not change. The second thing is the statistic. It's not statistics. Statistic is the characteristic of a sample. And it tells the summary information about mean. For example, mean is a summary. If you try to describe it through standard deviation, if you try to describe it through variance, if you try to describe it through range, if you try to describe it through median, mod, anything. So it tells you about sample. But statistic has one thing, that it has a random value. What do I mean by this random value? Is that, let's suppose you have a class of 50 people, and now I am taking a sample instead of collecting data from the population. So I randomly select 25 individuals. I just randomly call roll numbers, and I collect that data from 25 people. I will get a mean, average age from my sample. And after some time, maybe after 1 hour, I once again randomly take the sample of 25 students again. Once again, it's random. I randomly call names again without considering anything. I do not care whether they were previously included or not, no issue. It's random. 25 students again, and then I will going to calculate the average age. What do you think? The average age of my second time will be exactly identical to the first time.
No, sir. No, sir.
Because maybe some students they got missed, which were part of previous sampling, and some new student may be included, which were not part of my previous sampling. So that means the characteristic of a sample change, that is exactly opposite of a population. If I'm going to take sample of 25 students third time randomly, by putting all those names in a box and then selective, just picking up one by one randomly, and then I just take 25 students data again, do you think it will be identical to my first one or second one or both?
No, sir. It will be different.
No, sir.
I mean, maybe rarely it's possible that maybe I'll get an identical value. Most of the time, 99% of the time, it will be different. So the statistic has a random value. The characteristic of population has a fixed value, while the characteristic of a sample has a random value. So now I'll move in towards, I just want to test you people. Just try to listen to me carefully and try to think on this. That even before conducting any sampling, I know that if I will going to take a random sample, and from that random sample, I will going to get some summary data. Summary data mean either mean or standard deviation. Median, mod, variance, anything. And I take the sample for a purpose that I want to decide something about the population. And even before conducting the sampling, I know that if I'm going to take the sample one time, I will get one value. And if I will going to take the sample again, I will get going to get a different value. So the sample value characteristics or sample summaries, they will going to fluctuate, they will going to change. And they will be different from the parameter. So what's the purpose of taking a sampling? Why we take the sample and then based on the information from the sample, why we want to decide about the population if we already know that it will be different from the population?
Because we don't have any other choice. We have to take a sample or not take any sample at all. If we cannot we cannot include all the population, if it's not possible, then we do need to take a sample. And a sample, if not 100% accurate, it actually represents the population.
If not 100% accurate, it actually represents the population. Is it a statement that is contradictory even within the sentence? I can see a contradiction within a sentence.
Sample is taken from a population and there are certain assumptions, because we already know that it cannot tell about the whole population, but still we don't have any choice.
So the only thing that I want to tell you that it has a random value. But as you know that there is error linked with the all those things that you calculate using the sample, but statistics comes to the play a role here. Statistics may help you, facilitate you to calculate that how much error is possible. What do I mean by this? That one option for me is that I have no information regarding the age of MSc students. Second option is that I have even information and I randomly decide, okay, it's 22 based on my sample and it has some error. But just calculating, doing the descriptive statistics. That's my second choice. By linking it with the inferential statistics will going to facilitate me that, okay, let's suppose my mean is 21 and the error linked to it is about 0.5. That's estimation. And more specifically, that is interval estimation. So is it better than knowing nothing? That, oh, I know that my mean is 21 and the error possible is 0.5. So in that case, the population mean, knowing something that the population mean exists between 20.5 to 21.5 with my mean as 21. Do you think is it useful information other than knowing nothing?
Yes, it is useful.
Yes, definitely is useful. So when you do the statistics, the thing I want to tell you is that the characteristic of a sample has a random value. That's why you cannot directly decide. If you will going to decide it directly, okay, this is the representation of a population, in that case, maybe you have a huge error. Maybe you have a less error. You know nothing about that error. So the characteristic of sample has a random value while the parameter has a fixed value. Do you have any question? Do you have any confusion regarding this? Can I continue?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So normally, for example, if you want to calculate the mean of a sample, the mathematical calculation will remain same. It will be summation x. Summation means sum. It will be summation x over n. If I was going to calculate the mean of a sample, still the calculation will remain same. Summation x over n. So as the calculation will remain same, so we need to know that whether that is a parameter, that data is from the population or data is from the sample. So when we do a summary statistics, we have different symbols and we represent them with different symbols so that it will be clear that whether that characteristic is from sample or population. So when you calculate the sample mean, you just represent it by the X bar. Although calculation will remain same, it will be summation x over n. And when I look at any data set that has an x bar symbol, I know that it's a sample mean. If the data is from the population, we represent the mean by mu. It's a Greek word, mu. And once again, the calculation will remain same, summation x over n. But as the symbol is different, so I know that it's a data from the population. Another characteristic is standard deviation. So when data is from the sample, we represent the standard deviation by S. And when data is from the population, we represent it by a Greek letter, we name it as the sigma. And the hydra is a horrible representation of a sigma, but this appears something like this. When you have a data from the population and you have calculated the variance, you represent it by S square. And when the data is from the population and you calculate the variance, you represent it by, once again, the Greek letter, the sigma square. So with these different symbols, you can identify that whether the data is collected from a population or from the sample. Is it clear? You are very clear about this population. You are very clear what is sample. You are absolutely clear what is the parameter and what is the statistic. Do you have any confusion, anything to this point of the lecture? Just feel comfortable and ask.
Sir, I have a question.
Please.
Sir, we take a sample from the population because we cannot take into account the whole population. So we cannot say that sample is representing the population.
What was your question?
The question is that we take a sample because we cannot take into account the whole population. So is it wrong to say that the sample is representing the population?
We take the sample and we take it only because we want to decide something about population. So the compulsion for the sample that it must be representative of population. If it is not a representative of a population, there is no purpose of taking sample. So in order to make it representative of a population, we do certain things before carrying out the sample. We take care that what should be the size of a sample to make it representative of a population. First, in order to become a certain sample size must require, it can be greater than that, but it cannot be less than that. Although there is no fixed value, you can calculate the sample size, and I will going to tell you it's in the section when we're going to discuss the sampling, that how to calculate the sample size. So we have formulas to calculate the sample size for every population. It depends on the size of population. So depending on the size of the population, first we decide about the sample size. So first, secondly, we do statistics, inferential statistics on samples. By doing that, those statistics, although there is some possibility of error, either we do it through interval estimations, or we carry out interval estimation, where we have a range. Third thing, we carry out hypothesis testing. In that case, there is an option that there is a probability that maybe we are 5% chance that maybe we are wrong. When we make decision based on sample, sometimes it's 10%, so we'll discuss hypothesis. Secondly, we have to ensure the randomization. That's the third or fourth criteria to make the sample representative of the population. So we cannot be biased. So we ensure the randomization, we ensure the sample size. We do all these things to make the sample representative of population. Because if our sample is not representative of population, there is no purpose of taking the sampling. We want to decide about the population. That's why after calculating the mean or standard deviation, we do inferential statistics to make our decision more authentic about the population. Is it clear?
Yes, sir. Thank you.
Sure. Do you have any confusion? Just feel comfortable and tell me. Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
So I just switched to the new slide. It's variable and constant. Is it visible to everyone?
No, sir. Not visible.
So in this lecture, I want to discuss two more things. One is the variable and other one is the constant. Variable means the same. Variable is anything that changes. Any characteristic that is observed or manipulated, or it has at different values. For example, in your class, age is a variable because it changes. Everyone has a different age. Gender is a variable, male and female. Height is a variable. Weight is a variable. But in your class, your education level is same. So it's a constant for you, your class. So you all have 14 years of education. Hopefully you will have 16 years very soon, but to this point you are 14. So that is constant for your class. Secondly, you are human, hopefully. I teach human. So your species is a constant. Third, your nationality, all Pakistan, is a constant. When it comes to the department, the only thing I want to tell you, the constant, anything that is fixed and do not change. So when it comes to the department of zoology, the years of education is not a constant. The Apple scholars, they have 16 years of education. The MSc students, they have 14 years of education. So it becomes a variable at the state at the stage of department. But for your class, it's constant. So it variable. The only purpose is to tell you that maybe when it comes to the university, maybe we have more than one national. So maybe something is constant at one level and variable at another level. So in order to become a variable, it must need to change. If it is not changing, it's not variable. When it comes to the statistics only and only deals with variables. It has nothing to do with constants. Just give yourself little bit time. If I want to know about your years of education, what I will going to get? 14, 14, 14, 14, and at the end of the day, I have nothing else but 14. My average will be 14, my deviation will be zero. So there is no purpose of dealing with constant when it comes to the statistics. We only deal with variables. Is it clear now?
Yes, sir.
So that concludes my lecture for today. If you have any question, you can ask. You have 2 minutes to ask a question. If you have any question, then I will go to dismiss my class.
The students are asking if you are going to share these PPT with us or not.
Mean